Dear learners, so far we have learned the classification of functional foods and nutraceuticals according to food sources, nutrients and target organ system. Now in the forthcoming section, we shall study the classification according to modifications in foods, according to nutraceutical factors in the specific foods and mechanism of action. Let us begin with the fourth classification. Now the fourth classification is classification according to modifications in foods. Some foods are inherently functional and do not require much modification, whereas others do. Foods may be made functional by first elimination of components, for example toxins or allergenic proteins. Second, by increasing the concentration of natural components, for example fortification. Third, addition of components with beneficial effects, for example non-vitamin antioxidants. Fourth, addition of beneficial microbes, for example some yeast and bacteria. Fifth, replacement of a component, usually a macronutrient, for example fat replaced with modified or emulsified carbohydrates. And sixth, enhancement of bioavailability of components. Now, according to modifications, the foods are classified as fortified foods, enriched foods, enhanced foods, and altered foods. Let us see the examples of these classes. Fortified products means a food fortified with additional nutrients, for example, vitamin fortified milk and juices. Enriched food means a food with added new nutrients or components not normally found in particular food, for example butter with phytochemicals, probiotics, etc. Altered products are foods from which harmful components has been removed, reduced or replaced with another substances with beneficial effects, for example fiber as fat replacers in high fat products. Then enhanced commodities, meaning food in which one of the component has been naturally enhanced through special growing conditions, new feed composition, genetic manipulation or otherwise. Examples are eggs with increased omega-3 fatty acid content achieved by altered chicken feed, conjugated linoleic and enriched milk achieved by feed manipulation, etc. Now let us see the next classification, which is based on nutraceutical factors in specific foods. This classification is more apt when there is an interest in a particular nutraceutical compound or related compounds. There are several nutraceutical substances that are found in higher concentrations in specific foods or food families. These include capsaicinoids, which are found primarily in pepper fruit, and allyl sulfur organosulfur compounds, which are particularly concentrated in onions and garlic. Let us now see certain nutraceuticals that are considered unique to certain foods or food families. Now, foods for higher content of specific nutraceutical substances have been presented in this table. The first column shows nutraceutical substances or family, and the second column shows food of remarkably high content. Now this table shows that allyl sulfur compounds are present in more amount in onions and garlic, whereas soybean and other legumes contains isoflavin like genistein and diazin in more amount. Quercetin is present in onion, red grapes, citrus fruits, broccoli, Italian yellow squash, whereas capsaicinoids are present in pepper fruit. EPA and DHA are present in more amount in fish oils, whereas lycopene is present in tomatoes and tomato products. Isothiocyanates are present in more amount in cruciferous vegetables, cauliflower, cabbage, garden cress, bok choy, broccoli, Brussels sprouts and similar green leafy vegetables, whereas beta-glucan is present in oat bran. Conjugated linoleic acid is present in more amount in beef and dairy, whereas resveratrol is present in grape skin and red wine. Beta-carotene is present in more amount in citrus fruits, carrots, squash and pumpkin, whereas rosemary contains more amount of carnosol. Teas and berries contains more of catechins, whereas adenosine is present in garlic and onion. Indoles is present in cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, kale, Brussels sprouts. Turmeric is a good source of curcumin, and grapes, strawberries, raspberries and walnuts are good sources of ellagic acid. Red wine is a good source of anthocyanins, whereas 3-N-butyl phthalate is present in celery. Most plants contain cellulose, so they are good source of cellulose. Lutein and zeaxanthin are present in kale, collard, spinach, corn, eggs and citrus fruits. Psyllium is present in psyllium husk, and monounsaturated fatty acids are present in tree nuts, olive oil. Inulin, fructooligosaccharides are present in whole grains, onions and garlic, whereas yogurt and other dairy products contain lactobacillus and bifidobacteria. Catechins are present in tea, cocoa, apples, grapes, and lignin is present in flax and rye. Now next classification is, it is based on mechanism of action. This system groups nutraceutical factors together regardless of food source based upon their proven or purported physiological properties. Among the classes are anti-carcinogenic, antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, osteoprotective and so on. This classification would be helpful to an individual who is genetically predisposed to a particular medical condition, scientists trying to develop powerful functional foods for such purpose, persons or planning diet, and product developers to develop a new functional food. The different classes of nutraceuticals are as follows. First, nutraceuticals having anti-cancer properties include capsaicin, genistein, diazin, alpha-tocotrienol and gamma-tricotrienol, conjugated linoleic acid, lactobacillus acidophilus, sphingolipids, limonene, dialyl sulfide, hazonin, alpha-tocopherol, entrolactone, glycyrrhizin, lutein, carnosol and lactobacillus bulgaricus. Second is according to the positive influence on blood lipid profile. The examples are beta-glucan, gamma-tocotrienol, monounsaturated fatty acids, quercetin, omega-3 PUFAs, resveratrol, tannins, beta-sitosterol, saponins, guar and pectin. Third is antioxidant activity, conjugated linoleic acid, ascorbic acid, beta-carotene, polyphenolics, tocopherols, tocotrienols, indole-3-carbonol, alpha-tocopherol, ellagic acid, lycopene, lutein, glutathione, catechins, gingerol, chlorogenic acid and tannins. Fourth is anti-inflammatory. They include linoleic acid, EPA, DHA, gamma-linoleic acid, capsaicin, quercetin and curcumin. Next is osteogenetic or bone protective nutraceuticals, which include conjugated linoleic acid, soy proteins, genistein, diazin, calcium, casein and fructooligosaccharides and inulin. Now let us conclude, learners. In the preceding section, we have seen the classification of functional foods according to the modifications in food, higher content of specific nutraceutical substances and according to the mechanisms of action. According to modifications in food, functional foods are classified as fortified products, enriched foods, altered products and enhanced commodities. The classification of foods with higher content of specific nutraceutical substances contain several classes. As per mechanisms of action, nutraceuticals are classified as anti-carcinogenic, antioxidant, anti-osteoprotective, anti-hypertensive and anti-hypercholesterolemic.